You know what? Screw it. Screw it, screw it, screw it. I'm doing this. I'm doing this now. Hey everybody, ChaosLight55 here. Finally doing Sonic CD. Finally want to finish Sonic CD. Finally, finally, finally. Bah, you're being lazy. Goodbye, old Tails save file. Don't need you. Metal Sonic mod, made by Fan. Okay, so Sonic CD, my favorite classic Sonic game. Favorite. I personally think Sonic 3 is best, but my personal favorite is this one. Don't know why it is, it just is, I guess. But, yeah, basically it's general Sonic stuff. Beat Egghead, and... yeah. Save the world. Beat Egghead, save world. That's about it. Basically, the plot of this game, Dr. Egghead, Robotnik Ivo dude, has chained this little planet to the real planet that this planet shows up every once every few years, and he wants to use it to take over the world as usual. Because he never learns. He sucks at his job of being evil. He sucks. He really does suck. Oh hey, I do have 50 rings. So, this is going to just be an all chaos world run. Well, time stone run, whatever. I'm not gonna really go through the effort of finding the metal generators because I don't want to. I just wanna play through the game like I normally do. So, that's exactly what I'm going to do. Yeehaw, let's do it. Okay, so. Interesting thing about the special stages here. They kinda are, you can see, and you probably already know, because if you're watching this, you're probably already familiar with Sonic CD, because I don't tend to be that popular. But I don't care. Popular since. Because I don't know. I just don't care. But yeah, you can tell perspective's a little wonky and it's a little hard hitting. This is PC port version Steam thing that was made in 2011. It got a few updates for the ISO version, and that fixed the whole hitting the UFO things. So that makes it a little easier to get time stones. But no such luck for this PC. Players. And also, unfortunately, the ISO version of Sonic 2 didn't get ported, so that's annoying because I really wanted that version because it has my favorite Sonic stage in it. The unused Hidden Palace Zone got re-added in as a secret level in Sonic 2. In that version of Sonic 2, which is one reason why I wanted it to the PC. I mean, come on, it's... Did you hear the beta music that was used for that stage that was supposed to be cutscene thing? I mean, come on. That music's pretty freaking beautiful, and I like it. Of course, it's not my current favorite track. My current favorite track happens to be Undertale from Undertale. Creative name, I know. Of course, this is going to be going up after the Undertale thing's over. We've already finished recording it at this point. December 16th. Yeah. We've already finished up recording everything, and we just gotta upload it. Well, I gotta finish editing a dunk-ton parts, but you already know, because that'll already be up before this goes up. Because I gotta make sure from now on, if I'm uploading a series, I finish every video beforehand. Because I guess I'm a lazy dude, and I don't, like, I, for some reason, get demotivated and don't finish things. So, you're seeing this? Great job, future me. You did a good job, and you got this finished. You got your favorite classic Sonic game recorded for everyone to watch you screw around with and fail at. You're not good, because you're only okay at the game. You're not good at it. And I suck. But hey, at least I'm having fun with this. But yeah. Metal Sonic mod was made by the same guy who made the... made these Metal Sonic hack of Sonic 1. Metal Sonic Hyperdrive. So yeah, Dark Island, I think, is what he was called. So that's a promising thing. It's really just a character swap and a name swap, but really special, and that's about it. But of course, this is a pretty short game, so I don't gotta worry too much about, about not getting done quick. Not very many parts, and not very many things to do. But I gotta do my best to win, because, I mean, come on. It's my favorite Sonic game, and of course I'm gonna win if you see it, because that's how Let's Plays work. You upload, people watch, and they already know the outcome. Unless it's a game that has super bad endings, and you're playing it blind, they already know you win. Case closed, sayonara, goodbye. Heh. But from the looks of things, I'm actually blazing through this first stage, and getting these Chaos Emeralds flawlessly. I'm just not gonna bother trying to remember to call them Time Stone, because I won't remember and I'll keep getting on to myself about it, so I'm just not gonna care. I mean, caring, if I cared about it, it would be more annoying. But as long as I don't care about it, things are a lot better for me. Okay, so this is the first boss level. Bosses are this game's weak point. That invincibility box right there just guaranteed that I win without getting hit. Like, see? Watch. He falls. One, two, three. He's dead. I mean, look, that was pretty pathetic, Egghead. Even for you. And that's it. Palm Tree Panic was cleared. Next, we're moving on to the... can't remember off the top of my head. But just, oh yeah, they inserted a lower voice. They lowered the pitch of Sonic's Yes voice clip. Whatever. Oh, Collision Chaos. Okay, there's Amy, and I'm just going to stand up here so I can watch. And oh hey, someone's coming to kidnap Amy, who's not Metal Sonic. It's Metal Sonic 3.0 from Sonic Rivals. What sense does that make? It doesn't make any! But, does it matter? No, it's a mod! It's just Metal Sonic... It's just Tails' version of Metal Sonic playing in for regular Sonic. Not really a big deal, but... Metal Sonic... One of my favorite Sonic characters. I don't know why, I think it's... I'm a little petty where I... tend to prefer... prefer design stuff over... character stuff. I don't know why. I mean, I know it's petty, but I don't care. It's my personal preference, and, well, it's gonna stay that way. Can't let stuff get to you like that. You got opinions? Well, everyone has opinions. And here on the interwebs, opinions are something a lot of people like to get mad at. Oh, and I just realized I'm screwing up my ring collecting, so I'm gonna need to go to a different timeline to get more rings! And we get more rings in order to ensure I get to get all the time stones as quickly as possible so I can get a good future as early as possible. Of course, the bad future doesn't seem to be that way. It doesn't seem to not be that way, I mean be the best way to do that. Because bad future is harder than normal timeline. Present's harder than normal timeline, but easier than bad future, and good future is better is the easiest, because all enemies are poof, I think. At the very and of course, come on, stop bouncing me everywhere. Come on, this isn't annoying. This isn't fun. Getting bounced around isn't fun. This isn't why I like this game. Certainly not why I like this game. I like this game because soundtrack, level aesthetics, multiple timelines, and fun stuff. Exploring the stage rather than just speeding by everything in the blink of an eye. Or taking your time, or I don't know. I'm just getting a little flustered trying to defend this. Something that happens way too much for me. But regardless, I have a lot of stuff I want to do, a lot of games I want to play, and a lot of things I want to get done. I probably won't, but I want to. I want to continue failing at Spelunky, because I still fail at Spelunky. I want to do other stuff. I want to do some Let's Plays on different games. I want to get better with editing. I want to get better with commentary. I want to get better with a lot of stuff. But I gotta keep going, and hope you guys are willing to put up with me. So that way I can. Well, I guess it technically doesn't matter if you're watching this or not, because I'm still gonna upload, even if I suck, because that's the only way I'm going to get better, and people are eventually gonna watch me. Because if I don't, then I'm never gonna get better at commentating by myself, and that's not very good for me, because I want to, but I can't. But if I can't, then there's not much of a point. And if I let myself just be dictated by who's watching me, then I can't get better. Because then I will never want to upload, and I'll never be able to do stuff to get better. So I just have to hope people enjoy what I make, and if not, oh well, I just gotta get over it and try my best to improve. That's all I can say. I mean, everybody's got to start somewhere, and I started crappy, and I'm still kind of crappy, but hey, I can get better. There's much room for improvement. I mean, no one's perfect. No one starts being able to be super awesome with their stuff on day one. So, why should I expect myself to? I shouldn't, that's why. So I'm not going to expect myself to. I'm not gonna think I'm the best, I'm not gonna try and pressure myself to be the best. I'm gonna be myself, and improve myself. I'm gonna do everything I can to not let stuff stop me from being myself and doing more, and improving myself. Okay, so. Oh, Smash! Already old news, but I'm actually pretty happy for the final DLC characters from Smash, even though I'm probably not going to be getting them for a while. Corrin and Bayonetta, yeah. I'm not really I haven't played Fire Emblem Fates because it's obviously not out, and I'm kind of poor, and I, again, for Bayonetta, well, not same, but similar, poor, and don't got a Wii U. I mean, I'm not expecting to be a big fan, but she at least seems like an interesting character, and not sexualized in Smash Bros., which is why people could, like, M-rated game now! Yeah, but... They don't seem like they over-sexualized her that much in the thing, aside from the banter between her and Pick, with the way she talked. Oh well. I'm more interested in Corrin, though, but... Because, I mean, even though I haven't gotten Fire... I haven't played Fire Emblem Fates, I am a... Or Fire Emblem Awakening, or many other Fire Emblem games. I still am a Fire Emblem fan, sort of, I guess. Because, I mean, even though I've really only played two games, it doesn't really matter. I guess. As long as I... Because gameplays are similar between games, they're just... improved over time, I guess. You're still moving the basic concept's the same, I should say. Move units around an area and beat up enemy armies. That's about it. But hey, I don't know. Maybe I'm just stupid. I mean, it's obviously a good game because people are selling it, and there's so many characters in Smash now. It's like Pokemon, Mario, Fire Emblem, the three most represented things in Smash right now. Not even Zelda can compete with Fire Emblem at this point. Because Zelda's got like Link, Toon Link, Ganondorf, Zelda, and Sheik. Fire Emblem's got Marth, Ike, Roy, Lucina, Robin, and did I say Ike? I don't know if I said Ike, but... And now Corrin, so... Maybe they're about the same, maybe it's a little more, I'm not sure. I'm kind of a little disappointed that they didn't pick more from the ballot, or... But, hey, what can I say? I gotta do my best. I just gotta not worry about that. Because, I mean... Hey, they seem like they're putting a lot of effort into these characters, and they seem really good, and I really want to play out of some sometime. So if I get Lucas, and Ryu, and some of the DLC stages, but... And, well, of course, now Cloud, because Cloud's out. Been trying to actually play... Oh, yeah. Final Fantasy VII. I've never beaten it. Period. Like, I've played it, and I'm trying to beat it now, but I never had in the past. Like, eh. When I played it, it was originally on a PlayStation 2. I was playing the PS1 copy on a PlayStation 2. I didn't have a PlayStation 1 memory card at the time, so I literally had to go through it in a single sitting. As you could probably guess, that didn't... As I can probably guess, that didn't turn out too well when I got a game over. Because I was young, and I was a little stupid, and... I lost against some easy bosses I probably shouldn't have, but hey, when we're younger, we tend to be less skilled at some things. Well, patient-related things, like Fire Emblem and... other RPGs. Well, some of us do. Not everyone, as a kid. Not... Maybe even not most kids, but I know I was. And, I'm, awful, I guess. I don't know. I just like to have fun with my games. And that's why I'm doing this, because I don't... Because I want to get better, and I want to share my experiences. But I can't do that if I'm exactly poor. If I have poor... As you can tell, speaking issues. But hey, if I keep trying, I'm going to eventually get better, right? I mean, I have to at some point. So I'm gonna try. Anyway, that was our fourth time stone right there. So we only have three more to get. So, yeah. I need to stop playing with that. Okay, this is the Collision Chaos boss. As you can see, Amy's right there waiting for us. This boss is pinball machine. This is more one of the bosses that people tend to not like so much. I can understand why. It can take a long time or it can be done really short. Let's see what we can do about it. Let's see if we can somehow not take it too long. Yeah. Nope. Ow. Okay. Okay. I want to also sometime do the Mega Man Zero games, because, I only really played first and last Mega Man Zero game, Zero and Zero Four, I still really like them. And I've tried playing through another one, but, at least I've played through more. At least I've played more Mega Man Zero games than I have Fire Emblem games. Yeah. So, I've also played through more Mega Man games. Oh, another Mega Man game I want to play through on the channel is Mega Man Unlimited, a fan game. It's a pretty fun fan game, a pretty good fan game, a pretty hard fan game, and sometimes a pretty stupid fan game, but it's a fan game, and it's okay, and cool, and wonderful, and free. And probably not going to think about doing Mega Man X Street Fighter, even though it's a fan game that was officially licensed by Capcom, because it kind of lacks a little of the good innovations that we made, like not a password system, because an actual save system. But of course, I can't do anything about that, so. I liked my save systems. I'm glad they were implemented. I'm glad that Undertale breaks that fourth wall with the save systems and plays it like a fiddle. Alright, so we've beaten the first two zones. Okay, we can go through another zone this episode. We're gonna blast through this game at Sonic speed. Tidal Tempest. This game's equivalent to the Labyrinth Zone, the Sonic Water level. It's not really that bad, actually. I mean, there's this one annoying Crusher section where the water's constantly rising, and you're riding a platform that can eventually crush you, but, hey, you wanna know the... Oh, but, okay. But, hey, okay. I need to get my priorities straight and decide what I'm gonna talk about. Okay. Music for this stage. I prefer the American one. Da 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 da. I prefer the American one for this one, just because this one's model, it's all mystic and woo. American ones, I can't really specify it specify why I like it over the international version, but, well, Japan, Europe, I guess, but. Stop saying that so much, okay? Oh, I'm missing no block. But, okay, yeah. We got it. And talk. Okay, I like this one I like the American track over because it just has a, this one just feels like more ambient music, which doesn't really work too much. I just don't like it the way it sounds, this ambient music sounds. Meanwhile, the American version is all upbeat and yada yada ooh, and it's all rhythmic and just, Okay, let's move on to another topic before I lose myself. Oh, right. I plan on doing more stuff. I already talked about that. I lost my rings. Okay, looks like that's a way to break your topic. Realize you've lost your rings. Okay, I need to go get 15 more. This has provided me a perfect time to talk. Alright, so... Another game I want to play, Guacamelee, Super Turtle Championship Edition. I mean, I have the build, I can run it on my computer and record it. So, I'm capable of doing it. I just have to actually do it. But, I know that once I get it done, I can be happy, hopefully. Hopefully. This level's slow. I think I should have expected anything less. Okay, just don't get hit, and you're good. Okay, I just need 8 more rings. Oh, there's a ring box. Okay. Guacamelee Super Championship Edition. I want to play it because it's a interesting game. It's Metroidvania meets Mexican. Mexican stereotypes and wrestling and wrestling moves, and they have a move called the Dashing Derp Derp. What's not to love? They have all kinds of references to NES games. Not just Nintendo specifically, but NES and, well, a few other games, like, and a few other indie games, like, Castle Crashers. That's another game I want to try, but obviously I don't want to do Castle Crashers alone, because it's a co-op game. Why would you want to do a co-op game alone? You just don't do that. You don't do a mainly co-op game alone. I mean, yeah, sure, you could call it Guacamelee and mainly co-op game, but it's not the same. You can play Guacamelee alone and be completely fine. But there's just something special about playing Castle Crashers with other people, you know? That's why I want to wait on that one, but I have a lot of ideas. It's just not a matter of if I want to do them, but if I do them in the first place, because, you know, whole kind of motivation issue that I've been having. If you haven't noticed with all my canceled series, that I eventually want to do, but I kind of get lazy or unmotivated and I don't want to do them anymore. And it sucks because I want to do them, but I just lose the passion. I lose the will. I lose the want to do them for some reason, and then poof, I give up. Like they never were intended to happen. But I will do them one day, and I'm going to make myself do them one day. And I'm gonna try and be better at it. And not make it seem forced, because even if it is going to be forced, I can't let myself feel that way, because that'll just ruin things. I gotta force myself to do stuff, or I won't do anything when I want to do stuff. Like, it's hard for me to explain, anyways, but it's like, I want to do stuff, but at the same time, I lose the want to do stuff. Yeah, that makes absolutely no sense. I'm sorry. But regardless, I'm going to try to. It's not going to be a chore. That much is guaranteed. I'm not going to make myself do something if it feels like a chore. But I'm going to make myself do something. Because I just keep being lazy. And I hate it. I want to get better, but I can't get better if I don't do anything. so I have to do something. It's not a matter of, like, eh. You know what? Let's talk about something else. Like, the fact that I'm almost done with this stage, the fact that I've almost collected all the time stones, the fact that I really like this game and I'm about to get an extra life through that ring box that I just grabbed, the fact that I just fell down a pit. I don't know. I'm gonna talk about something. Oh, hey. End of stage, cool. Alright. Hey, I think I've done a better job with commentary this time. I mean, it's not... I mean, I'm not the best, but... I feel at least I'm actually being able to talk without long stretches of awkward silence. Because that's something I've easily had a problem with. And problem being an understatement, I obviously don't have a high opinion of that. Hey, I hit that UFO! Okay. That makes up for considering I hadn't hit that one when I did hit it, so I guess that's fine. Okay, so yeah, the hit detection probably should be fixed, but they don't want to do it, so... Because it costs too much money for them, apparently, so... Yeah. Okay, if I ever get a good... If I ever get a... Oh, no, no. No, I'm gonna... No! Okay. First screw-up special stage. It's fine. I've got two more special stages to do, and that's perfectly fine. I have plenty more chances to get it. I'm not gonna ruin it, so. Oh, I did not realize that was, oh cool, I didn't even know that was a thing. Okay, I'm just kind of surprised at that thing. Oh, yeah, beat him. I was just trying to get... Right there, I was just trying to get... Be fast so that way I could just carry this as quickly as I could. As much as I could with me. Because invincibility boxes and boss areas... Is that really necessary to make something easy? It's like... Sure, if you give me an easy option, I'm going to take advantage of it, but... Was it really necessary to add him if he ain't in here in the first place? Okay. Egghead's almost done, so... Here we go. Dead. Like, seriously. That was easy. Even without it, I guess, so... That doesn't matter much. Alright. Next time, we're gonna be going through more zones. Probably finishing the game in two parts. Cool. Bye.